Today, we will present a very brief introduction to the optical concept known as Etendue, and how it can be used when designing projection systems. We will define Etendue mathematically, talk about a very important property of Etendue, its conservation, and discuss the Etendue of DMDs and some various projection light sources. Etendue is a geometric property of light that quantifies how much space the light takes up spatially and angularly. Ultimately, it quantifies the throughput capability of the optical system for systems where the light needs to be coupled. Mathematically, it is the product of the area of a source or pupil and the solid angle that the light emitted from that area subtends. If we assume a circularly symmetric source shown in cross-section above, Etendue can be simplified to the equation shown. As the area of a light source grows, the Etendue grows. And as the solid angle grows, the Etendue grows. Etendue has units of length squared. An extremely useful and important property of Etendue is that it is conserved in a perfect optical system. In the example above, we show an image of a source being formed onto a DMD using a converging lens. At any point in the optical system, Etendue can be calculated, and it will never be less than the Etendue of the original source. For the example shown, the Etendue calculated using the area and cone angle of the image will be greater than or equal to that calculated at the source. The light can converge slower, resulting in a smaller half angle and a larger area than the previous case. Or the light can converge faster, resulting in a larger half angle and a smaller area. But Etendue remains constant. In practice, Etendue does grow due to unintentional or intentional diffusion, scattering, aberrations, and diffraction off of surfaces and through apertures. This is an unavoidable consequence of the use of imperfect elements and the second law of thermodynamics. But Etendue will never decrease. Because of this property, the component with the smallest Etendue in the system will dictate the throughput of the system. Generally, this is assumed to be the DMD, and a system design is started with this component. The calculation of Etendue of some various available 1080p DMDs is shown in the table. The illumination cone angle is dictated by the effective tilt of the micromirrors because it is not desirable to capture flat state or off state light in the on state projection pupil. The area of the DMD is fixed by the native pixel pitch and resolution, and is adjusted with a cosine factor due to the obliquity caused by the required tilted illumination. And finally, the Etendue is calculated using the equation described previously. As long as it is desirable to capture all of the light, the light source's Etendue should not be larger than the DMD's. Some of the most common light sources for projection systems are shown. Lasers generally have the smallest Etendue, with small emission areas and angles. Phosphors emit light in a wide Lambertian profile, but because the excitation spot size and shape is controllable, there is some adjustability to the resulting Etendue. LEDs also have wide Lambertian emission angles, but the area is dictated by the LED design and fixed by the manufacturer. LEDs generally have a large Etendue relative to the other sources. A lamp's arc emits light in all directions and is shaped by the elliptical reflector for use in a projection system. The area emitting the light is actually a volume taken up by the arc plasma. The result is a medium Etendue relative to the other available sources. Large Etendue sources require large lenses and DMDs and generally result in a higher cost projector. But Etendue is just one of the many items to consider when building a system.